I made them a better world. A world where everyone could live in peace without competing for resources. But people didn't appreciate the better universe I made them. I needed something to occupy my time, where I could lay low and avoid everyone that wanted to avenge themselves. I found the perfect place. Rampart High School. No one would look for me here.
Alright, so what you guys have to understand about the universe is it's a crazy place. There's a lot of people in it. If you understand the physics of how the world and how the universe works, you'll understand why I made the world a better place.
Aren't you concerned about, like, all the people you upset?
No one understands how difficult this was for me. I killed my daughter, but it had to be done. Actually, that reminds me. There was something else I was supposed to do today.
Oh, I remember. Oh, dang.
Mr. Thanos, I have a question.
Your mama's so fat, Thanos had to snap twice for her to disappear.
Oh, snap! Oops, my bad. Maybe I can fix this. I can not only make a better world, I can bend reality and make a perfect world. All it takes is a...
Some people say a man is made out of mud. A poor man's made out of muscle and blood. Muscle and blood and skin and bones. A mind that's weak and a back that's strong. You load 16 tons, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, 'cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. I was born one morning when the sun didn't shine. I picked up my shovel and I walked to the mine. I loaded 16 tons, a number 9 coal, and the straw boss said, well, to bless my...
It was a normal Wednesday morning when Robert Brown was rudely awakened by the sound of his alarm, ready to continue the monotonous rhythm of his daily life. Robert began the morning, by diligently brushing his teeth. Back and forth, back and forth, back and forth.
Hello?
Robert was confused. Robert entered his dirty and dismal vehicle, planning a drive to clear his mind. Robert tried to stifle his internal despair with low-quality music. But it was absolutely no use. Stepping into the picturesque landscape, Robert took a stroll in the city park, where the neighborhood children often harass him for money.
That was one time!
Unemployed and single, Robert has plenty of time to sit down during the middle of the day.
Shut up!
Robert tried to run. Robert tried to hide.
Who are you?
But couldn't help but curse the heavens in futility.
La 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 la.
I was born one morning when the sun didn't shine. I picked up my shovel and I walked to the mine. I loaded 16 tons, a number 9 coal, and the straw boss said, well, bless my soul, you load 16 tons. What do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, cause I can't. The company store.
Oh, your daddy's rich.
singing. Yes, you spread your wings and you take to the sky. But till that morning, there's nothing can harm you. Yes, with Daddy and Mommy standing by.
Fish are jumping and the cotton is high. Oh, your daddy's rich and your ma is broken.
Guys, we can't cover basketball 2 weeks in a row.
Well, we have to do a segment on something. Why don't we just cover the trash habits of the school?
I don't want to do that.
No, wait, I'm telling you, the basketball game is the way to go.
We did basketball last week.
All right, then let's do a segment on the cell phone game.
The what?
The cell phone game. Haven't you heard about the disappearances going on around the city? Supposedly, they're from the cell phone game.
If you don't even know what it is, just leave long enough alone.
Hang on. So you're telling me that the disappearances around the city are caused by something called the cell phone game?
Yeah. No one knows what happens when you start to play, but apparently all you have to do is text a certain number and you're in. And once you're in, you have 2 weeks before you're out.
So what's the game?
So during that period, you have two options. The first is to find a protective object that causes the bear deep emotional or physical pain. And the second way is by bringing someone else in the game. That extends your time.
Bringing someone else in?
You can bring somebody else in, you just have to send them a text saying, welcome to the game. And they're in with all the strings and rules attached.
But why would anyone want to play this?
Just think about how much fun it would be to get back at anyone who's ever messed with you. No one would be the wiser.
No, Nathan, we can't do that. And don't go play this game. It sounds really dangerous.
I'm not gonna play. What do you think I am, stupid?
Please, I want you to promise me.
Okay, I promise. Sure, bro. It's all good.
What were you thinking? You promised me you weren't gonna do this, Nate.
I know, but it's okay, I already have it all planned out. And I don't really believe it's true anyways. Besides, if it's true, it's too good an opportunity to pass up.
Nate, if this is real, you're in serious danger right now. You only have 2 weeks to find a protective item.
I know, which is why I already sent the text to Zach.
You did what?
Kinda freaky, right?
Nathan, if this whole game is true, then you're pretty much a murderer now, and Zach's dead.
Look, I have it all figured out. I don't think the game's real. I'm just in it for the ride. And plus, even if it is real, nobody really likes Zach anyways. He's always been a jerk.
All right, class, I have a serious announcement I need to make. One of your fellow classmates, Zachary Condon, has gone missing. His parents are quite worried, and we really need anyone that has any information to step forward and tell us or the proper authorities. This is serious.
Nathan, don't say anything. Just don't. Don't try and stop me, Ian. If I'm gonna survive, then I need more time. You're willing to kill someone for just a little more time? What's going on with you?
I know, but I know who I'm gonna curse, and trust me, nobody's gonna miss him, I promise.
Who are you going to text? Nathan, this is not right.
It's too late anyway.
Nathan, no.
So, I need some help on this section.
Hey, is this your idea of a joke?
Gavin, calm down.
No! You know what? I won't calm down. This idiot tried to get me killed, and I bet you got that other kid killed too. What was it, Zach? You don't get it, do you, Nathan? I'm already in the game. I always have been. I know the score. But unlike you, I never cursed anybody else.
Well, if that's all true, then how are you still alive?
They were my dad's. He was killed in action and it still hurts. So I wear these as my protective item. So I thought I'd let the psycho know that he didn't get any additional time from trying to curse me. I've already been there, done that. My time's almost up and we haven't found anything that could work as a protective item.
Nathan, we'll find one. I know it. We'll keep looking.
Ian, will you just stay with me tonight? I don't want to be alone.
Yeah, maybe we should stay here at my house. I think it'll be safer.
Okay.
Just in case. Please don't go after Gavin.
Just give me your dog tags.
It doesn't work like that. It has to be a personal connection. It has to be yours.
Just give them to me.
Nathan.
You know what?
Fine. You should just accept things the way they are and die with dignity. You're not going to get away with this.
Let's go, Ian.
You're not going to get away with this. You're gonna pay. He's gonna come, and he's gonna drag you off for all you've done.
Nathan?
Ian,
what?
He's here.
Hold on, come here. Nathan, calm down.
No, please.
What's going on? Nathan! Just hold on.
I
Nathan? Nathan!
Alright team, let's make this quick. I'm sending two of you in. I've disabled the alarm systems. You guys need to sneak in and be careful for any other hidden alarms or movement. I prefer if you bring more ammo on missions like this, John.
It's a stealth mission. 10 bullets is all I need.
You will need to find Paul's computer and insert the flash drive. By doing that, I will have access to all of Lucas's right hand's information. That, including Lucas's current whereabouts. Finish our final plan and to eliminate Lucas for good.
Heck yeah! Let's do it!
Woo! I'm gonna go ahead and start working on the plan. You guys rest up for a bit.
Hey Kat, I'm going on the other computer real quick. I'll be right back.
Sure. Yeah, go ahead.
I'm so glad all of this is almost over. I mean, it's gonna be wonderful when Kat gets her rightful inheritance back.
So, what are you gonna do with your guys' cut of the money?
I'm probably gonna start a bakery. Quit this type of life.
What can you bake?
I can't. Who said you need to bake to make a bakery?
I can bake.
See? You can be the first employee. You can be the janitor if you want.
Hey, did you get what you needed?
Yeah, have you planned out our next mission?
Yeah, I'd like us to go tonight.
Wow, don't you think that's a bit soon?
Tonight is the last night he's at this location. It's our greatest chance of ending this now.
Alright, I'll trust you on this one. Can you put this on your computer?
Yeah, sure, but...
It's a surprise for later. Don't open it until I tell you.
Okay.
So, about dinner on Saturday.
Can we talk about this after you come back? Like, the file?
Yeah, sure.
Okay, I guess I will talk with the rest of the team and get this going.
Alright, sounds good.
Alright everyone, let's regroup and get the sun. So I went ahead and made something new for each of you guys. They're wireless heart rate monitors, that way I could track you guys from here. They also defibrillate you, as long as you're not shot, of course. Alright, so let's go ahead and get strapped up and head out. Today we take back what was rightfully mine.
Woo!
Lucas is upstairs in his bedroom. Good luck. Mission start. Guys, the comms are being jammed. Do not continue the mission.
Hey, you guys there?
Are you guys still there? Do I continue with the mission?
Continue the mission.
Okay. What?
Ah! It's a setup. Abort. We gotta find another way out. Let's head to the basement.
What happened? Are you guys alright?
Max and Jay are dead. Lucas has trapped us in here. We're gonna try and find another way through the basement.
Alright,
fine. Just you two try to get out.
Alright, we'll be safe.
Well, John, it's just you and me. In case you can't tell, you're on home turf, buddy. And the crowd's cheering for me.
I'm not letting you get away with this.
Casinos. They banned me. Thought I cheated. Thought I had some sort of special trick up my sleeves. When in reality, just remember to count my cards.
10 bullets is all I need.
No! No!
Hey, Kat, I think it's time you play that video. It's a little hard for me to say words right now.
Hey, Kat, if you're seeing this, it means I'm dead or dying. But it also means I was able to get close enough to end this once for all. The file that you just opened activated a bomb that was strapped to me.
Oh, sweet, naive Catherine, huh? If it wasn't painfully obvious by now, I was the one that killed our parents. It's easy to fake a death. It's harder to fake a will. It was honestly their mistake for leaving me out of their will. I don't know what they were thinking. I didn't expect them to set up a second account for this, a second account for you to start your rebellion against me.
I want you to take that money and use it for good. If you got some sort of dream or aspiration, or even start a charity if you want to.
It was because of you that all of this had to happen. When you were snooping around for intel, I got a connection into your computer. I knew you were coming. I knew about the heart rate monitors and how you could invert the pulse to stop a heart. Really, all I did was shoot John and Alex. The other part was you. This didn't have to happen.
I just want you to still be happy, even if I'm not here. And my final request, as selfish as it may be.
Kat, it's your overprotectiveness and your need to know that got you half of your team killed. And I'm coming for you next. What's so funny? What's so funny?
I forgot the other computer.
What? What other computer?
Carry on our legacy.
Hey, did you do what you needed?
Yeah.
Thank you.
You've received a letter, Miss Carmelita.
I do not want to read right now, Alfred.
A refill, miss? Something bothering you, miss?
Oh, Alfred, ever since my brother was killed and my fiancé of 3 days left me at the altar, I haven't been able to sleep.
I'm very sorry, miss. Any news on your father's coma?
Oh, yes, that too. I wish that blimp never hit him.
It was very unfortunate, miss. What is it, Miss Carmelita?
It's from my brother's murder! It's signed, Ricardo! Who could that be? Who are you?
My name is Ricardo.
You killed my brother!
No, I am your brother.
But what's going on? Who's dead?
Oh no, it is not I who is dead. It is my brother, Roberto, who is dead.
Ricardo, no! Why would you do this?
I had no choice. He kidnapped the sister of my father's, wife's, daughter's, neighbor's, who blackmailed him because she knew he was having an affair with the mayor and she was going to expose him. Ricardo, no!
I thought you were dead!
Of course he did. Roberto
is my evil twin. He has been posing and telling people lies about me, and he locked me in his closet for months.
Why would you do this?
Because he knew a dark secret about me.
And now that I have escaped, I can reveal the truth to the whole world.
How many long-lost brothers are there?
When did you awake from your coma?
10 minutes ago, I broke out of the hospital and came straight here to tell you that Roberto is responsible for my coma.
It was I who steered the blimp into him.
But how? How could you do such a thing?
I'll tell you why. Roberto found out that this is not our real father.
Who would have guessed?
It was hard to believe. I had to get rid of him.
And now, I must get rid of you!
You killed my brother!
I'm very sorry, miss. Any news on your father's coma?
I knew this story.